You know, every time you do one thing, because I think the other thing that might step in is some people may feel you have to be at a certain level to have a portfolio. Like you have to have a portfolio, you know what I'm saying, where you have these big Fortune 500, you know what I'm saying, companies on there as people you've worked with, when it doesn't matter. If you shot your dog, you know what I'm saying, you can add that to your portfolio early on. And when you get more work, that portfolio is a living document. I look at it very similarly to a resume. You have a master resume, and that has like that's the resume that's too damn long. Right, that you can't submit to most places. And then from that master, so you always have a record of all of it, so you don't forget, you know how you wrote it up, all of that. You then create a specified, focused resume for that particular job. If this is a sales position, if this is a digital marketing position, if this is a engineering position, whatever. And with creative portfolios, I think people should keep in mind that you can segment it the same way.